Joining me now is Diana Radcliffe, the treasurer of Friends of the Bluffton Dog Park. Hi, Diana.
Hi, good morning.
Where is this dog park going to be?
The dog park is going to be in Oscar Fraser Park. If you drive into the park off Bluffton Parkway, off Goaty Road, off Schultz, the entrance to the park is there. When you drive in, the Public Works Building is on the right-hand side. The next piece of land will be the dog park.
And what is the status of the project right now?
Well, we have exciting news. After a long time in several different sites, the town has approved that site to be used for the park. So we had a survey done this week, which was the first step, and now we start the planning process. Last year, we had formed a planning committee for a different site, and we invited members of the public to come and give us their ideas, and we had some ideas, and we made a list of the basic components for the park. On Wednesday, the 22nd, at 4 o'clock, we're meeting at the park to show people the land, and then going to a meeting at 5:30 at the Bluffton Chamber of Commerce to discuss the ideas that we've formulated already and any new ideas so that we can put them on the drawing and present them to the town.
And is the public allowed at that meeting?
Yes, we welcome the public to come to the meeting.
And how can people reach you for information or to volunteer?
Okay, we have the board members. Philip is our president and the official liaison with the town. Pike Jones, who has 40 years of building experience, is coordinating the construction committee. Daniela is a member of Rotary and a local realtor and our secretary. And I am the treasurer and chair of the finance and budget committee. So all of our names are on our website, which is blufftondogpark.com. You go to the board member page and you can get their emails, or you can do the general contact form if you have specific interests or questions, and we will get back to you.
And what kind of volunteers are you looking for?
We're looking for people who are interested in the park, who might help us fundraise, do projects with us, work on the details of the park. Anybody who has an interest and or a dog who wants a park in Bluffton.
And what kind of amenities will you have at the park?
We will have two fountains which have been generously donated to us by one of the gated communities, Belfair actually, and we'll have at least two separate areas, one for big dogs with a separate entrance, one for little dogs with a separate entrance, and we're hoping to have a third area when we get the survey and space permitting for elderly dogs or people who don't necessarily want to be in the fray of excitement of a big pack of dogs, where they can go in and just relax and enjoy the park from the side.
What other projects do you have on your calendar right now?
Well, our other main project that we do is Bark in the Park, which is an annual fundraiser. Last year with the hurricane, we had to postpone it, so we're planning on doing that sometime in the spring or early summer. We need volunteers to help with that, to contact vendors, to help with the setup, to help generally through the whole day. It's a very successful fundraiser for us, and we're planning to do it again.
And if people aren't able to make that particular fundraiser, how can they make donations any other way?
Well, the best way is to use the website, blufftondogpark.com, because we post new news on there all the time, and the contact information is on there, and the board members' emails are on there too. So that's really the best way to get in touch with anybody.
Well, it sounds like a fabulous project, and I know the dogs and the dog owners are going to be very happy when it's completed.
It is
fabulous. Thank you so much for being with us, Diana.
We're looking forward to it so much.